everyone. Oh my God, I'm so excited for tonight. I am going to bring it to the runway, RuPaul's Drag Race. Some of the girls from season 10 are gonna be there. There's gonna be, starring is gonna be Kim Chi, of course. There's gonna be Monét Exchange. There's gonna be Miss Cracker. There's gonna be the Vixen. There's also gonna be some public figures from Toronto. I'm from Toronto, Canada. There's gonna be Sofonda A. Cox, and there's also gonna be Jada Hudson. I was actually disappointed that Dusty Ray Bottoms wasn't gonna be there because she's another one of my favorites and she's so funny. I don't know if you saw the last episode. Today is the 12th of April, so tonight is gonna be the fourth episode. I'm PBRing it because I'm not gonna be here to see it, but I will be able to see it tomorrow afterwards, which is gonna be a lot of fun and very interesting. So I really like Dusty Ray Bottoms. I really enjoyed the last episode, which was episode 3, and it was when they did when they tried to promote RuPaul's chocolate bar, and oh my God, like between Monét Exchange and Dusty Ray Bottoms, I was dying of laughter. It was so funny. They were so comical. So I'm really excited for tonight, and I have some friends coming over, and I just wanted to do a quick tutorial of what I'm gonna do my makeup tonight. I was actually thinking of doing a ponytail and adding extensions in, but I'm actually really happy with this. It's kind of raining outside right now, so I'm not really happy. The sun keeps peeking through, so I don't know where this weather's gonna go, and I really don't want my extensions to get ruined. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just keep this cute little top knot on, and it's usually one of my go-to looks when it's really quick or trying to steer away from whatever weather is out there. But yeah, I really was hoping to do the ponytail, but that's okay, we can do that another time. Yeah, so I'm gonna show you how I did this look. So I did touch just slightly on the Fenty Beauty body lava. It's in brown sugar. I am gonna add that at the end, but I literally just received it in the mail, so I just wanted to just try it quick. It's incredible. So I will do a whole tutorial on that, and look out for that. Stay tuned, keep watching. All right, so I already prepped my face. There's foundation and primer and serum and everything. So I'm just gonna jump to the colors and go with what look I'm going for, because if I show you what I do with a foundation every single time, I mean, it's not really educational, so I'll just go ahead and just skip over that. There's a video that I did on that, the contouring video, which I'll add the link down below, and then we'll just go ahead and continue. So I already have concealer on my eyes. So I'm gonna start with this color right here, all over the lid, the M536 by Makeup Forever, just to give it that nice natural base. I'm gonna start working on the crease, and I'm gonna go with this brown right here in the M630 by Makeup Forever, and I'm gonna go with a fluffy blending brush. I just want to push that up, but try to keep this nice and light, the lid, okay? So I'm gonna go with the precision brush and just add dimension, but I'm just gonna dot it in rather than drag it, because I'm just gonna go in and buff it out with the fluffy blending brush. I just back and forth dot it. Good with that. Actually, I'm just gonna add a little bit of highlighter on my brow, just a little bit of concealer there, a really light color. And then I know I'm kind of going over the colors I just did, but I'm just gonna buff it out. Yep, the Lavender Lust illuminating stick by NYX. I'm just gonna add that there. Add a little bit of I514 by Makeup Forever, just with my finger, just to right. I'm just gonna go back with my fluffy blending brush. I'm not gonna dip it in the color again. I'm just gonna go in and just buff it out. Cool. And I'm going to be using the Jet Black by NYX for the gel liner. So I'm just going to rush through it, and you can go ahead and see the winged eyeliner tutorial that I show you in the pinup and skin prep tutorial. Now I'm gonna go in and just start for the bottom lash, and this is where all the colors happen. So I'm gonna use the NYX gel in white. I'm gonna use it with a pointed concealer brush. Not gonna pick up too much. Just wanna go ahead and line the lower lash bed, but just a little bit. But you just want to go ahead and just define a little bit in the inner line, in the inner eye. Now I'm just gonna use a flat concealer brush. I'm gonna go in with the Full Throttle Shadow Stick by NYX, and it's a number 6, it's a turquoise color. And I'm just gonna go ahead under the white. I'm just gonna grab some like that. Just to define it. Because what I'm trying to do, so the reason I'm doing that is because I'm gonna go over the turquoise liner with a turquoise shadow. And so I want the textures to merge together very well. So I just wanna go over with the shadow stick first because it's creamy. So then when I add the shadow, it's really gonna come together and it's really gonna make it pop and stick and make it waterproof for the rest of the day. Okay, if it's not perfect, because you're gonna go over it with a shadow anyway, you just want to get the texture of the creaminess in there. Okay, just want to go over the white just a little bit more, just one last time before I put the shadow in there, just to make sure. To be honest, if you get it on your lash, if you get the white gel on your lash, it's okay, because when you put the mascara afterwards, it just becomes like a it's gonna thicken up by that time, that's gonna be like a primer. So when you put your mascara on, it's really gonna plump it up even more, so it's quite alright. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in with Parrot by MAC, the corner crease brush, and very gently. What I do so I'm not dragging and I don't have deposits on my face because it's a metallic color, what I like to do is just dot it in very gently and then go over it afterwards, so then like there's the product is already there. So just like that, dot it and just build it up and go back, right? And then do the other eye. Right, and now you could just go ahead and drag it out, just like that. You just want to keep it underneath your eye. You don't want it to line with your gel liner. It's really not necessary because it just has to stick under your eye. That's totally fine. Yeah, just blend that out. And it's good. Then I'm going to go in with a lighter turquoise color. This is Aquadisiac by MAC. I'm just going in with the same brush so they have like the same kind of color. And then again, dot it. And the other eye. And then just drag it over. So it gives it that, because it's a lighter turquoise, it really gives it that nice metallic definition to it. It just comes through. With that. Now I'm going to go in with a mascara, the V for Volume by Sofonda Collection, and it's in the turquoise color. And I'm just going to go in and line the bottom lashes very gently. I'm gonna start with the contouring, Fenty Beauty, and Espresso. Now before I start with the powders and setting everything, I'm just going to go in with the different V Volume Sephora Mascara Collection in the indigo color. I'm going to go over on top of that turquoise mascara I did before just to add a little bit of dimension on it and to add a little bit of color and really make that blue pop even more than it already does, but at least there's some sort of like contrast in it, which I really like. Now, here's a little trick that I like to do just to kind of make that contouring a little chiseled more than it already is. But just in case it's not, I mean, it really is this time, but I just feel like it just needs a little bit more dimensions with the fluffy blending brush. And I'm just going to blend the contouring just a little bit and just kind of bring that out. But just put a little bit of color because then you're stuck with like so much color on your face. And to go back, it's a little hard to do afterwards. So you see how, yeah, I love it. Okay. I'm just gonna go ahead and add some lashes to this. I'm just gonna go in with the Makeup Forever Stabilizer in the white color, just in the areas where I want the light of the flashes and the cameras just to reflect off. And you gotta be careful with this, guys. I know I've mentioned it in my other videos, but you really need to be so careful with the amount you've put on, because you don't want to really look weird, because it can happen really quickly. I'm just gonna go in and define my eyebrows a little bit. I'm gonna go in with the M630 again, the same one that I've used on my crease. I'm just gonna go in and kind of blend that in and out. I mixed liquid suede and tea and cookies. I'm just gonna outline my lips because I like using liquid lipsticks to outline my lips when I'm putting lipstick on, just because it dries to like a dry texture and it keeps it nice and matte. And I've bought so many lip liners that have promised to do a waterproof effect where it gives you the same effect that a liquid lipstick should do, but this is just my little trick where it just does exactly what I expect it to, and everything is good. While I wait for that to dry, I'm gonna go ahead with a little bit of brown sugar by Fenty Beauty. Wow. Beautiful is that? Oh my God, it's so beautiful. I love it so much. Just highlight some areas of my body with it. I'm gonna go ahead and just do my shoulder. Oh, it smells so good. Chest. Gonna put a little bit on my ears because my hair is up. Oh, I'm so happy. Now, just to bring out a little bit of that glow. Oh my God, it smells amazing. Asante highlighter in Golden Child, and it's broken. Like it, oh God, I hate when this happens. So you see it's like a nice golden pinky color. It comes with this vanilla color, and it's so beautiful. And the texture is velvety and very highly pigmented. So I highly recommend Vasanti as a highlighter. It's great, and it comes with these two colors. And this one's perfect because if you have a tan like I do, well, I sort of do, you can go ahead and just highlight the area. So I'm just gonna go dip that in. I'm just gonna apply that on my shoulder, this shoulder. Come on here. That's it. I think I'm good. So now that the liquid lipstick has dried up, I'm gonna go in with the Rimmel Oxford Street Fuchsia. And I had to really try and track this puppy down, because when they discontinued it, I looked everywhere over the internet and I bought like 5 or 6 of them. And it's just such a pretty color. And it's very hydrating. So I'm just gonna go in and just add that on. Ah, I love it. I just love it so much. But I just wanna share something with you. I ordered from Amazon it's called My Lips, and it comes in this little container, and it's a lip plumper, and it's silicone, so it's nice and soft. And oh my God, my lips are like twice the size of what it was this morning, and it's so safe. It doesn't even cause like a ring crease around your mouth. The lips are super plumpy. You see that? I really enjoyed it, and I'm really happy with it. So it's called My Lips, and it's on Amazon, and it was $15. It's so cheap, and it's like your lips just get really huge if you just keep going. So yeah, it's a really, really good product. So I highly recommend it. So it's nice and soft too. So thank you so much for watching this tutorial, Get Ready With Me, for the Bring It To The Runway, RuPaul's Drag Race, season 10. I'm gonna go in and watch that tonight. I'm so excited to see them all and see what they have in store for us to be making really fun. I'm just gonna go ahead with the Urban Decay, the D-Slick. I'm just gonna go ahead with that. Thank you so much for watching another episode of my tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe. I really appreciate all the views, and I really appreciate for all the people that are subscribing and getting the word out there. I really highly appreciate that. It means a lot. I'm just doing exactly what I love to do. Thank you so much.
Is a fucking